I mean, look, your kids are 9 years old. They got more sense than that, right?
I hope so.
I mean,
but I didn't at 16.
No, but you knew that if there was someone who rode on a bus with you
actually,
occasionally.
At 16, I was sort of coming out of it. Oh, 14, I would have been a mess like that.
16, you were making trips down to Chinatown to score prophylactics. Yes? 16?
17.
Drew, this story's not been told in a while. Drew, his father is...
Well, there were multiple layers to that. It wasn't just about my dad.
Oh, but your father's a doctor.
Right.
And he's was fairly prominent in the Pasadena community mm-hmm. that Drew grew up in. And it's not the world's biggest community.
Right.
I mean, in Southern California, you don't really have small towns. But if there was one, this could be considered a smallish, tight-knit community.
And
Drew's father being a physician, people knew who he was.
The probability of me seeing somebody I knew in any pharmacy was pretty high.
People knew the Pinsky boy. That would be Dr. Drew. And you could not buy condoms at the 7-Eleven back then.
No, no.
They didn't have them in fish bowls out front of the gay clubs that
no.
you could just grab a handful
of.
Oh,
no, you had to get Mr. Drucker to come out from behind the counter.
You had to go to the pharmacy and yeah. go to the back like it was the summer of 42 and go get the guy to get the condoms.
You line up with the old ladies
and
you wait your turn and he'd call to you from that elevated
right.
platform about way in the back. What do you need?
Oh, really?
Oh, yes.
You have to yell it out.
Oh, yes.
And Drew did not want to go to any pharmacies in Pasadena.
I think this is why I became a safe sex advocate, you know, because it was so difficult for kids then. It was crazy.
He didn't want to go to the ones because his dad probably knew the guy. The guy probably knew the dad, probably knew Drew.
Or
someone would have ratted you out.
A teacher would have walked in. Who the hell knows?
So Drew played it safe, and he drove out to Chinatown, where all us round eyes look alike. They don't know the difference between any of us. You could be black. They wouldn't know it. It doesn't matter. They focus on the eyes. They see the round eyes.
Also,
they don't know anything
else. If I saw a round eye walk in, I could check out who it was. You know what I mean?
Right.
I'd notice immediately.
Right, right. And this is my theory with why women have the Asians do the bikini waxing and do the cuticle pushes and do all this crazy sort of personal hygienic stuff. Because they don't look at us as humans and we don't look at them as humans.
Oh, please.
They really don't. No, it's true. When these women go and get the bikini wax and stuff, I mean, look, you go to the beach with a woman, she stands up in the towel in front of her, she'll hold the towel up above her. She'll wrap the towel around her waist just to take her shorts off. You know, just so you don't see her in a bikini bottom, for Christ's sake. Meanwhile, she goes down the street. She's spreading her cheeks while this crazy chick from Vietnam is dumping hot wax into her asshole and doesn't give it a second thought. Why? Not a human being to them.
Oh, my God.
You know what that little Asian woman is to them? What? It's like when the rhino's eating. It's got that bird sitting on its back that's eating the ticks off it. It doesn't know what it is. It's not another rhino. Who's it going to tell? Doesn't even think about it. That's the way Drew is with the Asian community.
Oh, that's me. Yes,
yeah, that's true.
Me.
So he storms into the pharmacy in Chinatown. And what do they have there? They must have, like, monkeys hanging in the windows, like dead monkeys.
No, it was not. Those days, a pharmacy was a pharmacy.
Regular pharmacy.
Yeah, the herbal pharmacy leagues, but gone away about 3,000 years prior.
And
resurrected in 1990.
He goes in there. Now, what kind of quantities would you buy the condoms in?
I just remember those sort of trays, those Trojans in the box.
Box? It was like, ooh, hey, lover boy, you know, you get 24 variety pack. You looking good. Is that what they do?
Right.
It's like 24-pack?
I can remember. You're stretching my memory right now, but I can remember getting a little like, you what?
Why do you need that many?
Not just that many. I mean, now, of course, it could have been the sheet white appearance and the panic and sweat that I was manifesting as I asked the poor pharmacist for the goods.
Where are you going, Don Juan?
Oh, my God.
Yeah. So you get the pack, then you go back, use them up, and then back again. The same place? Would you go to the same pharmacy?
Yeah.
Then would they know you after a while?
No. I didn't go that many times. I don't remember going that many times.
Nice. But that's smooth. And that's, listen, let's face it, everybody. If you're going to do something, you do it in front of a nationality that's not going to talk. And that's the Asian community. They don't talk. That's why we love these people. That's why we need them to do our bidding.
Before you say something more offensive.
It's true. It's true. It's not a bad thing. Hey,
if you want to be in the audience at Berman,
you think you could pull that off with Jews?
It's a show.
You think you could pull that off with Jews, Drew?
They be talking.
Oh,
818.
The Pinsky boy came.
755.
No, you'll never guess what he won.
4800. I'm doing a show, Berman to Berman.
He wanted condoms.
I'm going to be in the audience. 755-400.
What? I don't know. How old is he? I think he's 14. He's having sexual intercourse. Someone's got to call his father. He's not bar mitzvahed yet. I don't know how old he is. Are you kidding me? Could you imagine going to a Jewish pharmacy? Those people never stop yapping about your personal life. You go into that Asian pharmacy, you go, yeah, give me some condoms, give me some kerosene, a shotgun, a crossbow, some strychnine, and give me one of those rib spreaders. Yeah, thanks. You need anything else, Randi? Not say a word to anybody. All right. Let's take ourselves a little break. We'll be right back.